Hey everybody, this is Pablo with Mattress Makers.
And I'm Gabe.
In this episode of Anatomy of a Mattress, we finally got the Zenhaven Latex Mattress. Let's go. We finally got the Zenhaven Latex Mattress. I've always wanted to see one apart, and it's been a competitor of ours, so I always love getting latex mattresses and just seeing what's inside, because that's our thing. We do latex, we love latex. Let's see, what's the story behind this one, Gabe?
Yeah, so the customer, they had this for since 2016. Yeah, not too old, but you know, long enough.
Yeah.
But it's just too firm.
Yeah.
You know, they wanted to go softer and they like the feel of the coils. So they wanted to go with something that has springs in it. So they wanted to go with the hybrid.
Okay.
So a little bit softer, but they also wanted to go with the hybrid too.
Looking at it, it looks outside. It looks good.
Yeah.
You know,
light,
I haven't laid on it yet.
Slight impression, probably just because like the wool and it's every mattress settles, but otherwise looks great.
So in a queen size, this mattress retails for, I believe, $27.45. And right now, I believe as we're doing this video, it's on sale for about $25.45. And then in a king, it's about $3,000, maybe a little bit over $3,000. So this one is a
10 inch.
It's a 10 inch mattress. What we're gonna do is we're gonna open it up, pick it apart, just see what's inside. What happened to this mattress?
And we'll see how much latex is actually in it too.
All right.
All right, so let me open it up.
Little quick tip on open up a mattress is you just undo the threading right here. It just, the tape edge, this is called the tape edge. This keeps us the mattress closed. All right, we wanna just open up the entire thing.
I think
get a little snag.
Snagged right there. It's gonna be snagged all right here. I'm just gonna do this.
There we go, there we go. All right, let's open this up. Let's see, let's just look at the law label first. I'm gonna look at the law label, latex rubber. Okay. Now we got all the tape edge out. Now let's open this puppy up.
First thing, I mean, of course it's gonna be, it is glued to the top, right? The cover's glued to the latex.
Yeah, there is some glues, some points of glue. You guys seen some of our other videos. If you guys already know that, I'm not a big fan of gluing these latex mattresses. Does a couple things. Glues can potentially, depending on what type of glue you use, just can add more chemicals to the mattress. There's some glues that are definitely safer than the other. But also, you lose some of that flexibility of latex, like the flow, the movement of latex. So let's open up the cover.
The top side says organic cotton. I'm sure it's probably like a blend of organic cotton and like a stretch knitted polyester fabric, right?
I'm willing to bet that this is a blend. There's probably some organic cotton in there, but I'm willing to bet that there is.
Very similar to our one of our covers is Tornado.
Yeah, right? Yeah, I've seen this cover before.
This is the batting. Trying to see if there's any like a different color, like maybe the wool inside.
This
can
is not
be
look
if
like
it
wool.
Was if it was a bleached, right? But it doesn't seem like it's not what we use, right?
Yeah, this is definitely not what we use. This looks to me like a polyester cover or a polyester batting, like a Dacron type batting. The wool has like a distinct look to it and
it
a distinct
a different
feel to it.
So that's the cover. I mean,
so this is what's inside. This is, so you got the,
it's the quilting,
the ticking, you got the batting inside. I hate to say it, but it does not look like wool. Maybe if we have some here at our factory, it can show what this looks like.
Do a comparison, yeah.
Yeah, so you could do a comparison, you know, and here's the organic cotton fabric. Okay, so now we're here with the latex on the inside. Let's open this up. So this material, it's a non-woven material. It is used in a lot of covers to keep everything in, you know, to help with the shape and to get the tape edge and the flanging. This is definitely not organic, which if you're trying to go 100% organic, this is not. As you can see, we have four layers.
Like 9 inches, so that cover adds about an inch.
Yeah.
Right?
So there's like nine inches of latex on here. This latex right here, I'm gonna get a closer up look, but this looks like, it's a nice clean latex. Doesn't look like there's anything really wrong with it. How many inches on the top layer?
Just 2 inches. Under an inch and a, yeah, just under an inch and 3/4 maybe.
About an inch about and 3/4.
Yeah. Same thing with the bottom. And then you got 2 3-inch layers.
So 2 3-inch layers. So yeah. About an inch and a half in each quarter.
I had to point this out too, like the, you see the marks, right?
Yeah.
Probably a lot of times, you know, you don't see that, notice that in this mattress, right? The markings on it because it's all taped up and covered. But a lot of times this is, you know, inside the factory in production, they're trying to figure out, okay, what firmness it is so they mark it. You know, so they could just be a marking for to show them what firmness this mattress is.
Yeah, let's flip this around too. Like, this looks like it's, I'm gonna get a closer look. So you see here, you got the bigger holes right here, and then you have some smaller holes right here, and then some bigger holes, and then smaller holes. That's zoning of the latex, which zoning is supposed to give you different firmnesses and different feels throughout the bed. In our opinion, I think a lot of it is marketing, because the density is still the same with the ILD, and it doesn't really change the feel. In our experience, it doesn't really change the feel that much, but also everybody has different zones too. Someone who is 6'4" is gonna have a different zone than someone who is 5'2". So that's why I'm not a huge fan of zoning. It sounds cool. It sounds very like it might be useful, but it doesn't really do, I mean, it doesn't do much to it, at least in our opinion. We're gonna flip this latex over. Let's flip it over. All right.
All right.
Okay, so we just flipped it. One of my favorite things about this mattress, other than the fact that it's latex, is that it is double-sided. It's a flippable mattress, which if you guys seen any of our stuff or read our website, we're a fan of double-sided mattresses. You don't see them too often. This one is double-sided. Now, I think they might have different firmnesses on the different each side. I'm not a too fan, big of a fan of that. I like them being the same on the top and the bottom, so you can have the same feel. But other than that, I mean, this looks like a good mattress. I mean, so here's something that you're gonna notice with latex. So right here, you see that we have a seam with latex.
You can feel it.
Yeah, I mean, you can feel it without...
Without the cover.
Without the cover. Now, with the cover on, you shouldn't feel it unless it's a very thin cover.
Or you're a princess in the pea, right?
Yep, princess of the pea. You'll notice it. On a queen size, you really shouldn't have it, because they do queen, I see this more with California Kings.
Yeah, queen sizes, they do make them in queen size blocks.
Yeah.
You know, so it's not common to have that seam here. Some companies just saving, using all that material, right? You know, we talked about the cover being glued. I mean, all the latex layers are glued, right? So breathability, yeah, effective breathability, but also the chemicals, right? So people want a mattress without the chemicals. Adding glue to it, it's gonna add chemicals to it, right?
Yes.
So if you're wanting a chemical-free mattress, maybe not the best one, right? If I mean, when you're adding glues to it.
Yeah, in our opinion, I would rather have that, because it will change the feel. It definitely will change the feel of the bed. Uh-huh. But overall, I think this is it's a good mattress. You know, for being 6 years old, we didn't have any body impressions. Here, Gabe, you wanna?
Calls me Caleb all the time.
Slips out of my son's name is Caleb, and I have these Freudian slips. Let's see how it feels. Jump all up. Right. Let's do the firmness test.
Bottom.
All right. Whoa. Here, let me do the counterweight. Go for it.
For this thing.
All right. Gabe's our mattress model. I'm gonna give him your good side. So how does this feel? On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the firmest, what would you say?
I mean, I think they rated about a 7 or 8. I would say about an 8, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, it's firm. I'm a side sleeper, so it'll be a little too firm for me.
Yeah.
For my shoulder, right? I mean, I like to sink in a little bit more on my shoulder.
Yeah.
You know, it's not like there's big holes in it like we've been on some mattresses.
Yep.
You know, so it still feels supported. Yeah, it's firm. If that's what they were saying, it's firm. You can definitely feel it.
Yeah, actually, this side is a luxury plush. I think the other side is a firm.
It's a firm?
Yeah. So this is actually should be the softer side.
So still felt pretty firm. Felt supportive, though.
Latex, you're never going to get a super soft latex mattress, you know? I mean, well, I should say that. It's hard to get a super, super soft latex mattress. You can get some softness, but because of the density of it, it's not going to be as soft as some of these poly synthetic foam mattresses.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's the Zenhaven latex mattress in a nutshell. So I thought it was a good bed. Overall, I would give it, you know, a B plus at least.
Yeah,
The glues and all, you know, but you know, we can't win them all.
Right.
So, but yeah, it still looked like a solid mattress.
They do have what they said they had, right?
Yeah.
With the exception of maybe the wool.
It doesn't feel like wool to me.
Yeah.
It feels more like a Dacron polyester type material, which that would be ashamed if it is that. But other than that, I think we're good. Quick question, our comparable would probably be the Coronado series.
Yep.
and our Solana series. Those are our two most comparable ones, I would say. Even the Presidios too. You know, big difference is that we have that zipper top where we can do those adjustments.
Uh-huh.
We have a Tally Dunlop combo or all Dunlop.
Yeah, this is supposed to be all Tally.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
And from the looks of it, it's Tally. The Coronado and the Presidio is gonna be the Dunlop and the Tally, with Coronado's gonna have the wool in it.
Yeah.
And the Presidio is gonna be without the wool.
Yeah.
Our vegan one. You know, if you guys are on your mattress shopping journey, you're looking, hey, okay, let me start researching on mattresses. What do I need to look for? You know, in the notes on the page or on the link on this the page, you go and download a mattress shopping guide. It'll give you just tips and what to look for when you're shopping for a mattress, and you know, kind of help you be like a semi-mattressologist, right?
Yeah, you get to like Mattress 101. Yeah. Yeah. All right, you guys. Well, thanks for watching.
Yeah.
Subscribe, tell your friends, share, give us a thumbs up. Thanks. Bye. Hey everybody, this is Pablo with Mattress Makers.
And I'm Gabe.
And in this episode of Mattressology, we're doing anatomy of the mattress.